Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Garcia!
A singer in a smoky room, a smell of wine and cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night, it goes on and on.
From the Netherlands, machine gun Jermaine Wattimena!
Game three here at the Czech Darts Open, live from Prague on PDC TV. As our MC John McDonald welcomes our ref Paul Hinks to the stage, we've just welcomed Jermaine Wattimena, the machine gun. There seems to be a lot of Dutch support in here today. I have to say, it was a good reception for Jermaine and Danny Noppert earlier on. And he takes on Kevin Garcia, who, if you saw the name, you'd probably be flummoxed as to where he's from, but he's a Scouser. Actually lives in St. Helens. He's been playing on the Challenge Tour for a bit. This is a European Tour debut for him. He's earned the chance to play in the qualifiers by playing on the Challenge Tour and doing bits. He had a quarterfinal last year. He had a semi-final this year already. But five times he tried to qualify for a Euro Tour event prior to making it through this one. And he's got his chance. This is by far the biggest game of his PDC career. We have seen him play in UK Open qualifiers in the past. He's beaten a good mate of his, Stephen Bunting, in a UK Open qualifier. That was the start of last year. But I think to beat Jermaine Wattimena on a big stage...
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First leg, it's Jermaine to throw first. Game on.
This could be the highlight of Kevin Garcia's career if he wins it and sets up a shootout for a last 16 spot with the ferret Johnny Clayton. Paul Nicholson in the comms box for this one.
Yeah, I'm really buoyed for Kevin to get his debut here in Prague.
80.
We've already seen a bounce out in his warm-up darts and another bounce out there, so we hope that trend doesn't continue for him. But he's up against it here because we have Jermaine Wattimena, or J-Dub, as I like to call him these days. It's a bit of a sort of rap name for a
60.
Dart player. Because we've got JDZ and MVG and all of that. J-Dub.
I do not want to hear Jermaine Wattimena rapping at any stage of my life.
Okay, I won't mention it to him then. But it's a difficult game for Kevin because Jermaine has been seeded for a lot of events this
100.
Year. He wasn't for this one, but he still qualified. I think that shows a really good attitude from this player.
98.
Because he went there and he took out, was it Justicia, with a fabulous 104 average performance and donutted him 6-0. And he took out Gabriel Clemens as well to get here. I think Jermaine Wattimena is bubbling under the surface for something.
80.
And he hasn't started too badly in this one either.
Yeah, misses double 12 for 104 checkouts. Seen a lot of 10 plus checkouts already today. And one fall out the bullseye for a second 170. Danny Noppert having already hit one big
24.
Fish. He nearly had a whole school of them.
Game shot.
That'll do it as Wattimena moves into the lead. And he is flying.
Game on.
And has been. He's just been getting better, making more and more progress over the last 18 months or so, Jermaine. And this year, only once has he failed to make the final day of a European Tour event. So that just shows you that he's in the mix.
Is that the collective thing for a lot of 180s, a school of 180s.
Well, it'd be a school of big fish, wouldn't it? Or a pod. I'm not sure. But with 180s, certainly. Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure what the collective noun is.
I have to think.
136.
Good call.
This could be one, but it won't be.
Not,
have you seen much of Kevin Garcia play? I have to confess, it's the first time I've ever seen him play.
Yeah, first time for me as well. I've seen his name on a lot of qualification sheets and studied some of the games that he's played. And I think he's just gaining experience at the minute in order to potentially get himself on the tour full-time. I think that's the next step for him. And there are a lot of players like Kevin out there just waiting to get that opportunity. There's another one out of the board, and you've got to say that with his dorse going in so upright, he's going to expose a bit more of the wire than someone like Jermaine, whose dorse going still a tiny bit upright, but a bit more direct. And you can see that wobble of the dorse, and there's another fallout, you see.
The first 40. Thing I thought, having seen Jermaine, him throw it from the very first moment, it looks like he's... You watch Jermaine, it's a forceful, straight throw. Throws that straight in the double top. Garcia, it's a bit reachy. It's almost like he's reaching up and looping it into the ball. And we do see players with kind of loopy, old-school throws, like it's a Mickey Mansell. But you don't see Mickey's darts wobbling in the board. And there's not... It doesn't look like they're going into the board with a lot of force. And so any deflection for Kevin Garcia, whether it's the wire off his own darts, they're going in... Yeah, well... 40. You wonder whether they're actually going to stay there.
I get the feeling that this might happen a lot to Kevin because he's not reacting like this is something out of the ordinary. Yeah.
Well, if you're making a quarter final on the Challenge Tour last year and a semi final this year and you're losing one in every 10 darts, you must be a serious player.
Well, we've got some surefire Swiss quartz timing there from Dan Dawson.
100.
But you can see from that side on cam that there's another bounce out, so we get the marvellous and the extraordinary.
39.
But they do go in feather-like.
Yeah,
those points are quite long. I think if they were just a tiny bit sharper as well, they might have a bit 65. More purchase. But how many darts has he lost in this game already? And it's only the third
four
leg.
Five, yeah. It's... You know what, I remember, you go way back, I think it was the World Match Play. I think Rod Harrington and Keith Deller played each other, and Rod kept having darts falling out the board as Jermaine looks at double 18. And he is bossing this game, Jermaine Wattimena, 3-0 in double quick time for the machine gun. Huge leg of darts coming up, but I remember Rod Harrington, he was struggling to get his darts thrown out, sticking the board, and I think, to be honest, it's probably his throw had changed over time, and they weren't going in with the authority that they used to. And so any deflection or anything, the power was not there, and they just drop out of the board, agonizingly in some cases. Keith Deller seems to actually really enjoy the situation. But it feels similar, this.
Well, you would, because if you're Jermaine right now, 60. And you're winning, and there's another one on the floor, if you're Kevin Garcia's opponent at the minute, you'll be loving this.
Absolutely. No mercy.
There is a saying in darts, when your opponent... is getting bounce outs. We used to say this back in the 90s. It's music to my ears. So you just say music. Because every time he has got to pick a dart up off the floor, it's brilliant for you. Because he's getting 60, another 20 on the floor. But to be fair to Garcia, he's not playing poorly.
Well, he's averaging low 80s, and you would think you could stick another 5 or 10 points on that average. But Jermaine, giving himself a bit of time.
51.
He's probably coming back. I'm not sure, even if they go in the 60 and the 54, I'm not sure they're staying there.
Well,
you've got to think
40.
That J-Dub's getting this one this time, and he does. That's right in the middle. Very similar to the Czech Republic, that dart. Completely landlocked.
Well... Jermaine Wattimena is locked in to 100 average right now, and already, I mean, this would suggest that the conditions are very conducive to good darts, because Danny Noppert played some excellent stuff. Jermaine Wattimena is playing excellent stuff.
77.
And I tell you what, Kevin Garcia is throwing them, by and large, where he wants them to go. They're just not staying there.
97.
Justin Pike with a plus 95 average as well. So, look, this has been a really good start to the day in terms of quality. But Kevin Garcia must be absolutely screwing right now.
He must be on some sort of record for a Euro Tour for bounce outs. I cannot remember a game where I've seen so many.
I've seen Benito van der Pas have bad days. I've seen Danny Noppert have bad days. And neither of them are getting to the number of bounce outs seen here from Kevin Garcia. But they just don't have enough authority. That's what it looks like to me. I mean, you know his game better than I. And maybe being up on this stage, massive day for him, maybe there are a bit of nerves. And he's not got the power in the throw that he would normally have. It's a bit tentative, maybe.
No shortage of power on that double 16. And Jermaine Wattimena is having a day out here. Not only is he getting the fortune of all those darts on the floor from Kevin, but he is playing well. This is a tournament-winning formula that he's putting in this game.
Well, let's have it right. Kevin Garcia, every single dart could have stuck in the board and registered 60s and 57s and 54s 44. All over the place. And Jermaine Wattimena could still be beating him convincingly here because he's averaging 103.
Well, I look at the dart of Kevin as well. I think that dart 96. He's throwing is around the 23, 24 gram mark, maybe a tiny bit more.
And 25, actually, according to this sheet.
I think it's very bottom 79. Heavy because it's quite a small flight and a small-ish stem and a long point. For me, because he throws from 45. The back of the barrel, very much like Benito van der Pas. Mm. That's why it's going into the board very steep.
140.
Well, look, Kevin Garcia can obviously throw. He's got himself here, and he's had some runs on the Challenge Tour. And as I say, he convincingly beat Stephen Bunting in that UK Open qualifier last year.
Well, he beat Eddie Dootson and Cameron Menzies to get here, and they're players who are very 60. Handy.
Eddie Dootson's another mate of his, actually. A little St. Helens cartel in the world of darts. Oh, my. I mean, that's not caught the dart. That's not caught a wire. 40. That's just hit the board and come out, and it's got to be the angle that it's going in and a lack of power. It has to be.
We're going to have to find out from our backstage crew how many have been on the floor in this match. It has to be a record. But I really wanted to hit this. I'd like to see him get a leg,
57.
But it's looking very likely that he will not.
Double 16 to complete a whitewash.
28.
Not just
Kevin,
yet.
You require 88.
Come on, Kevin. We want you to hit this. Good line. Just a bit more south.
74.
And that was so close.
Jermaine, you require 60.
He won't get another chance. No, he will not. The machine gun wraps that up in double quick time. Kevin Garcia has had a nightmare of getting his darts to stick in the board.
It's not that he threw that poorly. He just could not register the points. But Jermaine Wattimena, no mercy whatsoever from the Dutchman. Powers through to the second round where the ferret Johnny Clayton awaits. That's three games down here in Prague at the Czech Darts Open. Coming up, our first Czech Republic player of the day, Karel Sedláček, taking on Brendan Dolan.
He really didn't stand much of a chance, 6-0 in record time. We saw you recently in the World Cup of Darts representing Team Netherlands, the first time we've seen the two of you represent the country in that competition. Clearly, you're really up for this match. I mean, you came out like a machine gun, right?
All right, but first of all, I'll tell you, I feel so sorry for him because a lot of bounces for him, many triples I see falling out, and I think 6-0 is not the score what it was.
Well, you know, both playing on the same ball, but I understand your sentiments there. Your reward for winning this match is you will play Johnny Clayton in the second round. Any thoughts on the ferret and his form recently?
I'm looking forward to playing against Johnny Clayton. We play a lot together, and always good games. And I'm looking forward to tomorrow.
We look forward to seeing you Saturday afternoon. Our winner, 6-0, Jermaine Wattimena.